So, your mother tells me you're different from the rest of your siblings. She tells me you're schizophrenic, which is why she put you here, is that right? You know you can talk to me. It's my job. Truthfully, I don't even think you need to be here. The doctor says your brain shows no signs of the illness, which I find rather odd. Why would your mom put you here if you don't need to be? I don't understand. Luca? Do you see him too? See who? There's no one there. Luca, you've been here for 3 weeks and have barely spoken to anyone. You need to tell me why. You don't want me to end up like them, do you, Tony? The ones tortured and killed for no reason because they were different, and because no one knew what was wrong with them. Luca, I think you should come inside. The storm's getting bad. You say you want me to talk to you, that you listen to me, but you're a liar. You think I'm crazy, just like my mum. Luca, wait! His brain upright, he'll end up like his neighbour Winnipeg. Winnipeg was just like Luca when he first came here. Hey Tony, how's the kid? Did he tell you anything? No, he didn't tell me anything. He keeps seeing things, but not like schizophrenia. It's something else. I just don't know what. You don't have much time before they start picking his brain like buzzards, Tony. I know. Look, Cal, I have to go. Good luck. You'll need it. Thank you. Luca. Call me if you need anything. No, no. Please leave me alone. I don't want them to come for me again and pick my brain apart. Not again. Please let me go. Sorry about that. You're back. Anything new with Tony? No, I don't trust him. You lied to me. You said he was like us, but he thinks I'm crazy, just like everyone else around here. No, no, no. He's the one who lies to you. No, no, no. I tell the truth. Well, if he's a liar, how do I know you're telling the truth? Listen to me. I said to you before, I said to you he was like us. Was, I tell you, was. And he still is, but not the same. No, 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 no. Not the same as he was before. Yet very different. Yes, very different. Different how? Tony used to work here when I came here, before they turned me into a loony. He worked here as a psychiatrist, he did. I saw him. He'd walk down the halls and start screaming like he got his leg chopped off, he did. Because he can see them like we can. Yes, yes, he can. He can see them, but no one else can. No, he would tell others what he's seen in the asylum. Tell them he saw them. The ones who would tell him about the torture they were given here. Why they're dead. Yes, they would tell him everything. He couldn't take it. No, no, he couldn't take it. The workers locked him up, they did. They locked him up right there in your room. In here? Why isn't he locked up now? Because he's dead, you silly goose! Don't you see? I woke up one morning and there he was, hanging from the fan on an extension cord he stole from the janitor closet when he was let out a few times. Yes, yes he was. But why? He couldn't take having the spirits visit him all the time, screaming at him. Why? Why didn't you help me? Oh, no. He could have never helped them. No, no. He couldn't. Because he couldn't help himself. Just like us. We're birds of a feather. Yes, we are. Yes. So, that's why I can see him, and no one else can, except for you. And how he can talk to Cal, the doctor who was killed by a patient last week. He did see what I saw in the woods, but he lied, because he didn't want to acknowledge what he was seeing. He was like that in life, too. Yes, yes, he was. He was like that in life. He thought he was crazy, seeing what he saw like me. Yes, he knew what they were, though. He knew they were things of the past. The visions he saw, the horrible stories they tell of what happens here. But he didn't. He needed the psychiatrist job, he did. So he didn't want to believe this place was so horrible. No, no, he didn't. And now he can never leave. No, no, never. This is his hell. Why didn't he try to ignore what he sees rather than be afraid? Because that's just it. He was afraid. Unlike you, yes, unlike you. Afraid not just them, but of himself. Yes, he was afraid of himself, but you're not afraid. No, no, you're not, but I am. I am afraid, not of them, but not of me, but the white coats. Yes, the white coats, they don't believe that I see ghosts. No, no, they don't. They believe I'm a loony. That I have the same thing that Tony had, which is what they say is schizophrenia. No, no, I'm not a schiz. They made me crazy, they did, yes. Poking at my brain, rearranging things all the time, yes, they did. But no, no, I wouldn't wish that upon my worst enemy, never. And not on you, no, never on you. But why even worry what happens to me? You have your own burdens to bear. I envy your courage, I do. I wish I could have that, but perhaps I do. I just hide it, maybe. But they're coming for you tomorrow. They're gonna make you like me. They're gonna make you a loony. Yes, they are. But I won't let that happen. No, no, I won't. How do you plan on doing that? Shh! Listen! The lock on my door. I picked it. Yes, I did. I picked it. It's unlocked. Then why don't you run? I have nothing. No, nothing to run for, but you do. Yes. When they open your door to give you your food, I will cause a distraction and you will run. Yes, you will run away. You will be free of this hell. But what about you? Why not come with me? You are my only friend here after all. Because I am gone already. There is nothing left of me, but you have it all, boy. Shh, they're coming. Be ready. Run, Luca!
Winnipeg, I order you to let him go now, or I will shoot.
Luca, just go! Run! But why? Why for me? Because you were the only one who listened to me. The only thing I have worth dying for. My only friend.